sharp as ever.
Beast fit for an ogre. You notice a peculiar dagger protruding from the tough, leathery meat. Strained by your clumsy technique, the blade snaps in two. Beast fit for an ogre. You notice a peculiar dagger protruding from the tough, leathery meat. You notice the blade is at an angle to the meat's grain. If you align the dagger with the grain, it should slip out easily. Thanks to your keen eye, the dagger glides smoothly out of the mystery meat. Mystery meat, tough as boar hide. Only the sharpest teeth could pierce it.
My, my, what manner of place is this? A path to redemption? Or a road to damnation? Hard to say, for your journey is just beginning. What would suit the occasion? The words to a lullaby, perhaps. The mouse smiled brightly. It outfoxed the cat. Then down came the claw. And that? Love. Was that? They do know how to write them in Cormyr, don't they? Well met, I am Raphael. Very much at your service. Neither. The fox, rather. Hiding, in a word. A silent observer, about to break the silence. Of course, what I have to say merits some privacy, as well as some more, let's call it, refinement. This quaint little scene is decidedly too middle of nowhere for my tastes. Come. There, middle of somewhere. The house of hope, where the tired come to rest and the famished come to feed lavishly. Go on, partake, enjoy your supper. After all, it might just be your last. Call it a ninth sense. What's better than a devil you don't know? A devil you do. Am I a friend? Potentially. An adversary? Conceivably. But a savior? That's for certain. Come now, why play hard to get? When you're in deep over your tadpole head. One skull, two tenants, and no solution in sight. I could fix it all like that. Take all the time you need. But make up your mind before you're counting down with tentacles. Try to cure yourself. Shop around. Beg, borrow, and steal. Exhaust every possibility until none are left. And when hope has been whittled down to the very marrow of despair, that's when you'll come knocking on my door. Hope. Such a tease. I'll be around, watching you squirm like a tadpole through a nice, juicy brain. All those pretty little symptoms, sundering skin, dissolving guts, they haven't manifested yet, have they? One might say, you're a paragon of luck. I'll be there when it runs out.
The Devil with the Silver Tongue. An old fairy tale my father read to me. The kind with a hero, a villain, and a moral. A farmer made a deal with the devil, so the story goes. In exchange for the farmer's dearest fruit, the devil granted him a bottomless coin purse. The farmer's dearest fruit, naturally, was no apple nor peach, but his beloved daughter. We can learn a lot from fairy tales, don't you think? Refuse him, no matter how tempting the offer, no matter how delicious the feast he lays out for you. The cost's always too great. That's because you still have hope. But when he becomes your last hope, remember this. He'll require of you only what you're least ready to part with. And then require more still. You might think you'd give up anything for a cure, but the devil won't take just anything. He'll take everything.
Bloody hells. Literally. Just when I think I've got a grasp on our dilemma, a devil shows up. No matter. We've dealt with every other oddity thrown at us lately. We can handle this one, too. Now, as for this Raphael, he knows our secret. He claims he can help. What do you make of him?
Anticipation. She is testing you somehow. About Raphael.
Actually, yes, you're right. Very intuitive. Clearly the devil was trying to sow doubt among us. I know people who work much like our new acquaintance does. You don't need a scourge or a rack to break people. Fear and self-doubt is sufficient. When actual pain comes, the victim's already done the heavy lifting for their torturer. There were no right answers with that devil. He was toying with his food, us. Perhaps sowing doubt is an old trick. Watch out for it. And for Raphael. This again. You're persistent. I'll give you that. Like I told you before, you'll know if I have anything to tell you. You've already pestered me with your notions once today. If I have something to add, I'll tell you.
Something over there.
Breeds madness. Can't afford to stay idle.
The pride of the gate. A big man does not fit in a small hole.
time wasted. Battle awaits.
Seems like a pack of goblins swarmed the Arbor.
Noble creature. She should be proud of the fight she put up.
More owlbear eggs. Already hatched. No point in taking these.
A shrine to Saluna in a grotto like this.
Feel that? Magic. A spell sealed that chest tight. Ow! Looks like this'll take some doing.
What's next, I wonder?
Something over there.
Well met.
My faith protects me. Saloonite prayer. How useful.
Thank you. hero at heart.
Almost pleasant traveling with company, if you ignore all the less pleasant aspects.
Seems like a pack of goblins swarmed the Abbey.
Noble creature. She should be proud of the fight she put up.
There for the taking.
An owlbear egg. These are supposed to be worth a fortune.
Bear eggs. Already hatched. No point in taking these.
Shrine to Saluna in a grotto like this.
Ow. Looks like this'll take some doing.
time to rest.
That might be worth a look.
Just an old prayer. Locked. My prayers are answered.
You should leave it, or even destroy it if possible. This rubbish is an offering to Saluna. At best, it's worthless. At worst, who knows? Could be cursed. Do not trifle with that moon witch or her trinkets. Only trouble will follow. Fine. Perhaps you can sell them for a couple of coins.
It hurts.
Worthless. Well, I hope, aside from the obvious.
A big man does not fit in a small hole.
Better get to work.
Where am I needed?
Whatever comes, I'm ready.
This devil, Raphael, flaunts his paltry wings as if he wants to impress us. You saw the red dragon slaying his infernal kin above hell's fires, did you not? Next to a dragon, the devil's a gnat. When I am Kithrak, I will take my Queen Vlakith his head as a trophy. Githyanki Knights, the riders that chase the Nautiloid. They are the commissars and enforcers of my Queen Vlakith's will. Vlakith bestows no greater honor. To wield a Kithrak silver sword is my destiny. I will earn my queen's favor, and I will conquer every layer of hell should she command it. The Geich are my kind's mortal enemy. It is not unusual for the Kithrak to give chase, to penetrate the Hells. This is unusual. But I'm not one to question the wisdom of my queen. I can see but to the horizon. Vlakith's sight pierces the many plains.
All's well, I hope. Aside from the obvious.
Needed.
One horn, the stink of Avernus, Advocatus Diaboli.
Well, I'll be God's damned. The Blade of Frontiers. Thought I'd shaken you for good. That'll teach me to underestimate you. bloody right. An honor to be chased by the Blade of Frontiers, but I...
A great heat roars through you. Her heat, fiery as the hells. Then you're lost in visions of demonic armies as you tear through a landscape of fire and blood, the Blood War. You saw it from above as the Nautiloid passed through Avernus. This woman was on the front line.
What was that?
Evidence. Proof that you're a devil. A gladiator in the archdevil Zariel's army.
I can explain, but it's a whole situation. If you just hear me out...
Another vision. Karlak's blade raised, slicing through devils, Zariel's servants, as her eyes dart around, seeking escape. Her rage and desperation seep into you. She is a victim of the Blood War, not an agent of it.
She's trying to trick us. Don't believe her lies.
You saw the truth. I never wanted to serve Zariel. I was enlisted in her army against my will. Forced to fight, and fight I did. When I saw an opportunity to get away, I took it. Finally home. Near it, anyway.
You served her. That's enough to damn you.
Will catches his breath and his lips straighten. Sheer dread twists his face.
You don't know what you're saying. You're asking me to trust a devil.
You know monsters, right? Better than anyone. Look into my eyes. Can't you see I'm not what you think?
Shit. You really are no devil, are you? I've been deceived.
Oh, thank the gods. Thought I was gonna have to take your head.
You would have died in the attempt. But there have been enough threats today.
Truce then, eh?
Aye. Truce.
I'm Karlak. But you already knew that. And you are... Well met, soldier. Nice to meet a friendly around here. It's been tough going so far.
I may not be a devil, but I can put the Blade's reputation to work. How would you feel about helping me kill some evil bastards?
Little background, if your moral compass needs something to point at. You already know I fought in the Blood War. I was good. Really good. Turns out, I've got a knack for killing demons. That made me a valuable... asset. Zariel, the archdevil herself, made me as her personal attack dog. I played along until I could get the fuck out of there, but devils don't like to lose their assets. Zariel liked it so little. She sent a bunch of goons, so-called paladins of Tyr, to take me back. Problem is, I'm not going. Don't worry, I'll lead the charge. But I could use your help. There's a lot of them and only one of me. After that, we can team up. Take Faerun by the short hairs. Sound good? Fuck yes! They cornered me outside the toll house just up the hill. Doubt they've gone far after the scorching I gave them.
Looks like your troops all trooped up. You'll need to send someone packing if you want me to join.
I'll catch up with you when it's time to camp for now. But don't get to any of the fun stuff without me. Got it?
No one back home will ever believe this.
You've been witness to a pantomime, I'm sorry to say. And I've played my part all too poorly.
It means that a reckoning's coming. And I'll be the one to pay up.
Chuk! What manner of hero is so shrouded in secrets?
I have never called myself hero. But I am bound to an oath. One night soon, when we make camp, the veil will be lifted, and I'll pay my penance. You're not in any danger, I promise. I can't say the same about me.
Not much use anymore.
Need anything else? Of course, but please, remember, you're not the only one in need. Thank you. Sylvanas be with you.
Thank you. Geneculamo in umbra tua parter arborum.
Sorry. I haven't fraternized with you much, and not sure I want to start.
Hellsfire. She's coming.
And you know what happens when you're naughty.
Gods damn it. Anyone but her.
Well, you absolute stinker. You kept me a secret. Time to let the Hellcat out of the bag. Call me Mizora. I'm Will's patron, the fount of his power. My pet's been unruly, and his leash needs a yank. We had a deal, Will. But Karlak's still breathing.
I've taken more pleasant shits than you, Mizora, and at least those can be buried after.
That's no kind of talk for a lady. By the way, Karlak, Zariel sends her regards.
You told me! Devils only! She's a tiefling, not a monster!
How precious. The little pupster's found his bark.
Clause G, Section 9. Target shall be limited to the infernal, the demonic, the heartless, and the soulless. Karlak meets the criteria, pet.
Trust me on this. He's the Blade of Frontiers.
Devil's plaything just doesn't have the same ring. Speaking of...
Oil burns in the fires of Avernus. The lightning storms of Dis strike his flesh. His soul passes through each layer of the Hells, gaining their essence and their torment.
That's better.
What the hells have you done?
A promise broken, a price paid. You know the terms.
Get used to the new form, pet. There's no going back. Some magic even I can't undo. Now, let's see how the frontiers fare without their precious blade.
Karlak, keep an eye on him, would you? I'll be keeping mine on you.
Oh, and Will, don't forget,
our pact still stands.
Ta-ta.
I'll be honest, soldier. I'm reeling.
Will hardly knows me, but he chose my life over his. Been a long time since someone stuck their neck out for me like that. You can say that again. When he was chasing me through Avernus, I thought he was just another sad merc. How wrong I was.
Gods damn her, straight back to the Hells. Just look at me. I did what was right, and Mazora made me pay for it. I'd be hunting devils and demons, she said. Traitors and hypocrites, heartless evils of all sorts, but not... not Zariel's victims. Not innocent tieflings. I'll say what I can, but it won't be enough. It's Mazora who grants me the power to conjure armor and cast Eldritch Blasts. Before I was infected, I could even call hellbeasts and summon festering clouds. But I promise you, every thrust of my blade and every flame I sparked was for the good of the coast. Ah. The one little question that put me out of house and home. I can't utter the terms or circumstances of the pact. I can tell you most all else, but the pact, I'm forbidden, unless Mazora permits it. But I'll say this. The moment I pacted myself to Mazora, I have not regretted for a heartbeat. It was my proudest deed. It was worth the sacrifice. All I can give you on that is my solemn word.
Spare me a moment, if you please. I've something important to discuss with you. We've been traveling together for a while now, and it's just about time that I shared something with you. It's a rather personal matter that I'll prefer to keep quiet, but needs must when the devil drives. I have no choice but to speak. You see, I have this condition. Very different from the parasite we share, but just as deadly. The specifics are rather personal, but suffice it to say that it is a malady I've learned to live with, though not without some effort. What it comes down to is this. Every so often, I need to get my hands on a powerful magical item and absorb the weave inside. Oh, staffs, tomes, cowls, the form doesn't matter, so long as it's brimming with weave. It's been days since I last consumed an artifact, since before we were abducted. It is time, and by that I mean it's imperative that I find and consume strands of weave at the earliest possible juncture. We've already done the finding. In fact, you have one in your possession. You know for yourself how hard won such an item was, and it will be no easier when even more are required to assuage my hunger. There'll be danger involved, or great cost. Splendid. Bit of boldness will serve us well. As luck would have it, you're already primed to give me exactly what I need. I will consume the magic inside. What was a powerful artifact will be rendered no more than a trinket, but it will save my life, even if only temporarily. I might need you to be more specific there. Just one artifact will suffice. Thank you. Magic, it's like a lullaby that sings to sleep the demon inside. A metaphorical demon, I haste to point out, but no less dangerous. And no less bound to wake up again to continue its ravages. Such is the nature of all monsters. Grateful as I am, the course of our camaraderie is much better served by not taking that particular detour. Not just yet. Sincerely, though, I understand I ask a lot from you with few answers in return. But in time, all will be told. My lady, I bow to your boundless kindness.
Gale slurped that thing up like a horse with a carrot. I hope he got what he needed from it.
It's said that anyone who bathes in the River of Blood emerges as one born anew.
It's a lot like that, I imagine.
I feel the weight of these horns on my head, curling upwards like a mammoth's tusks. I feel these ridges snaking down my neck, not to mention a few bumps and prongs in unmentionable places. But I haven't seen my reflection just yet. Be my mirror. What do you see? it's because you know the heart lurking under the horns. The people will see a curiosity, maybe even a beast hungry for their souls. But I will slay their monsters, keep them safe, and one day they will see the Blade of Frontiers again. A possibility that's kept me awake countless nights. But I don't have a clue where to start, other than play her games and play by the rules. That's the only language devils listen to. There could well be. She has the blighted thing. What I know of it is simply what has engraved itself upon my memory. My contract is very clear. I can bring Mizora no harm. She'll have to let me out of my pact willingly. The only way out is if I can out-bargain her. We're standing here with nothing but the clothes on our backs and the worms in our heads. We can. I'm sure of it. How glad I am that you see me as more than my patron's pet. Well met. Are you sure? The blade stands at the ready. And just when things were warming up.
I've known people who are hungry for power, but Gale takes it a bit too literally for my liking. I wonder how he does it. Why he does it. I'm sure all will be revealed in time, but I don't like it. A waste of perfectly good treasure.
Why do you insist on exhuming the past?
I was a slave. A vampire spawn. Kept by the Tsar family. Perhaps I still am.
I was never able to resist their commands.
But now, I've been conveniently lost. They won't ever control me again.
It's simple. Just find a vampire that will drink your blood and turn you into a vampire spawn. Their obedient puppet. In theory, the next step is to drink their blood. Once you've done that, you're free. And a true vampire. People think the biggest threat to a vampire is a cleric with a stake. It's not. The biggest threat to a vampire is another vampire. They're scheming, paranoid, power-hungry beasts. So why would any vampire give up control over a spawn to create a competitor? Trust me, it doesn't happen. I've already apologized. What more do you want? Unless you're looking for another nibble. No innocence. You have my word. Only villains that we need to kill anyway. After all, you know what I am now. I can fight with all my weapons, teeth included. And if I happen to drain the occasional bandit during a fight, what's the harm? They're just as dead. Excellent. Now, shall we go? I'm already feeling a little peckish. Darling, I thought you'd never ask. Lead on.
To do. Druids are going to get us killed. Nothing sacred about this lot.
Is that everything?
Looking for steel?
I have, well, something close. Looking for steel? I have, well, something close. Looking for steel? I have, well, something close.
Thank you.
These tieflings prove fragile. I have a mind to end their misery myself.
They make good bait, drawing attention away from us.
Judicious advice. How puzzling.
So, you know about these parasites. Will we survive them?
Only if my people extract them. The only other cure is the blade.
Okay. Wonderful.
Twice as tall as me, but I have half the bloody backbone.
But we don't know what that thing even is. And what about the crypt?
I'm telling you, it's a ship. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already. That's our ship. First you look, then you touch, then you take. The only thing we're sharing with you is our pointy ends. Get her!
Blood comes easy these days. Light on my feet.
Going.
Make way.
Over here.
Sometimes the only way out is through. Need to find a way forward.
Let's end this. On the move.
I am Fury. I am Death. Taking position. Nothing will stand in my way. On my way.
Whatever it takes. Take you.
Have you given a book? Everything all right out there?
You sound a bit shaken, boss. Hang on while I find the key.
You're dead!
Come on, you can't stay idle.
No more prayers, only dust and silence.
Who are those prayers for?
Normally the patron god is Alpheus, not here.
Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood. Ancient, indecipherable text covers the plaque.
A dead tongue. Whoever worshipped here must be long gone.
Time and the elements have left the plaque unreadable.
Ready.
Can't even catch my breath.
The dance macabre. Mutilate them.
Ignis!
Will ascend.
I wonder if this is worth the cost. Survival is all that matters.
Ignis!
I'm so tired. How do people do this all day?
No lock, no handle. How does it open?
Not recognize the language on the plaque.
That took the edge off.
There's no time to waste.
You do not recognize the language on the plaque.
Something over there.
traps. How considerate. Someone's left a trap out for us.
Watch how you go. There's a trap.
I prefer gold. I'll take it. Traps. How considerate.
There's a trap.
Visitors. Be careful. There are traps about.
Gale just
consumes magical items like I do wine. We truly are a group apart. Nevertheless, as quirks go, that's a new one for me.
Careful, I might. Scribes with swords. So much for the quill being my tier.
I wonder what was so subversive about their words that they commanded protection.
That's Jergal, scribe of the dead. Didn't think anyone.
What's that?
Elves, something just woke up down here.
Let them come. The darkness can be to our advantage.
Victory awaits. No time to waste.
Breathe deep and move.
On the move. Still on my feet. Never a dull moment. One day, I'll catch a break. Nothing important is ever easy. Swift as my feet can carry me. Relics are wasted on bones. We can make much better use of them.
inscription is in a language unknown to you.
A lot of effort to hide one sarcophagus.
So he has spoken, and so thou standest before me, right as always. What a curious way to awaken. Now, I have a question for thee. What is the worth of a single mortal's life? Curiosity. Nothing more. Wilt thou answer my question? So, I ask again, what is the worth of a single mortal life? In death, that is so. Very well. I am satisfied. We have met, and I know thy face. We will see each other again at the proper time and place. Farewell.
I wasn't expecting it, but I'm glad to have some company on this journey. This again. You're persistent, I'll give you that. Going to let this go, are you? You might wish you had. I worship Shah, the Mistress of the Night. It is my holy mission to oppose Saluna, her teachings and her followers. It hurts. Now that you have the truth, please don't make a big fuss about it. Forever, ideally. And you assume too much about what I can and cannot tell. Secrecy is everything for Shah's children. It is our code, our creed, our shield.
I even keep secrets from myself. I had my memories suppressed, so that nothing I know could be used against the Dark Lady. Once I prove myself, my memories will be restored.
I'm not sorry I kept this from you. Not one bit. Though, perhaps that might change. If you can show an open mind. As I said, Shah is my patron,
my mistress, goddess of darkness and loss. I assume you've heard of her. My Lady Shah is the Night Singer, the patron of darkness and loss. Most fear the dark, like children, because in darkness they see their fears reflected. But Shah teaches us to step beyond fear, beyond loss. In darkness, we do not hide. We act. Pain, hope, the promise of better days. All of these are heavy cloaks that bend our backs and burden our hearts. We shed those cloaks. Before Shah, we stand gloriously naked, beyond the vanities of mortals. We tear the institutions they trust, the so-called gods they worship, the lives they cling to. We destroy false idols, topple corrupt organizations, fight heretics wherever they're found. There's often suffering, death even. Many people break before they embrace Shah's truths. Curious. Most are afraid of my lady. I think I did well by joining you. Most agreeable company. The wound on my hand. It never quite heals. And sometimes it causes terrible pain to rip through me. It's my burden, though, from Lady Shah. I can feel her influence somehow. I cannot say. Not with what I can recall. But even then, it would not be for me to question her will. Lady Shah has her reasons. Difficult to say. Sometimes I wonder if it's supposed to be guiding me, punishing me, testing me. But perhaps it's none of those. Perhaps it's completely random. I'd like to hope there's more to it than that. Some meaning that Lady Shah will reveal to me when the time is right. Until then, all I can do is endure. It's less difficult than you might imagine, when you can't remember life without it. Pain is sacred to followers of Lady Shah. Pain will give way to loss and then to the peace of her eternal darkness. You can tolerate a great deal of suffering so long as it has meaning. Try my best. But secrecy is ingrained in me. Lady Shah considers it greater protection than any shield or armor. You already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? She took me in when no one else would. Without her, I wouldn't be alive. She's my mother. She nurtures me, cares for me, loves me. Don't believe the lies the Saloonites tell. What? besides my life's calling and the greatest problem I've ever faced? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's a deal. No, I can't. Quite literally, I mean. With my memory suppressed, I can't betray Shah's secrets. But I can't remember much of myself either. If I manage to return to Baldur's Gate and fulfill Shah's mission, then my memories will be restored. Of course, it is an act of faith, not to be undertaken lightly. Shah will reward me when I succeed. Fine. What's on your mind? I don't think I've ever had a confidant quite like you. And if I have, I can't remember them.
We have nothing more to discuss. Continue on thy way, as if I were not here. I must attend this place after so many years away. We will see each other again soon. When the time is proper. I do not know that hour. Any more than dost thou. But I do know that the longer thou standest here, the farther away our second meeting becomes.
Looks like someone wanted to bury their secrets.
This book is far lighter than it should be with such a massive lock. Does not take kindly to your tampering. A feeling like pins and needles lingers under your skin, pricking and prodding. Reverberates through your body as if you just slammed a hammer into solid adamantine. The lock doesn't budge. Despite all your efforts, the lock cannot be opened. And does not respond further.
There is work to do.
This book. book is far lighter than it should be with such a massive lock. As the lock opens, a loose page comes with it. Magic pulses from the parchment. What was once script is now an obliterated scrawl. You have a sense these are names, a list. But of what? These are the names of gods, once lost but now restored after the second sundering. The last three names in this book sit close together, but are so devastated by the scrawl as to be unreadable. Entire pantheons have dwindled and been reborn, silently recorded by this book.
On my mind, and, well, in it. Feed if you must, Astarion. But give me so much as a hungry look, and I'll drive a stake.
Time and the elements have left the plaque unreadable.
Mm-hmm.
matters to discuss. We meet again, as predicted. I shall be here in thy camp for whenever thou hast need of my services. There are many answers to that question. None are important. Correct. No. Beyond mortal realms, there doth exist an amalgamation of spirits akin to thine own, ensnared by the treacherous cult of the Absolute, felled in its name. They bear great discontentment with their destiny. For a mere pittance of coin, I might summon the worthiest among them to lend aid to thy undertaking. Most willingly, forsooth. Their passions doth run deep for what hath been wrought upon them. Should thou or any of thy compatriots perish, I will cleave soul to body once more. A matter of coin. Then I shall wait here patiently until it is acquired. Very well. Such is life. Outrage leading to a singular end.
I was just thinking about you and that delicious moment we shared the other night. The very same. I've had this condition for 2 centuries, but truth be told, you were my first. In all these years, I've only ever fed on beasts. Drinking the blood of thinking creatures is a different thing entirely. You were delectable. And now I can't help but wonder how the others taste. Alas. It doesn't hurt to ponder the question, though. Take Gale, for example. He strikes me as someone whose blood is rich, refined, like well-aged brandy. But the Gith, what in the hells would she taste like? Yes, heavens forbid we have an interesting conversation. Still,
I am intrigued by the possibilities. Absolutely. A mere thought experiment. So, in the spirit of theoretical questions, if you had to take a bite from one of them, who would it be? A fine choice. She is enticing. Although, the more I think on it, the hungrier I get. I better go find something I can actually get my teeth into. There's nothing that tasty lurking out in the woods, but I'll make do. Sweet dreams.
What's on your mind? We all have our burdens, one way or the other. Think of it as tribute, the kind a king might pay to a more powerful neighbor to avoid invasion. As long as I pay, there will be peace. But should I ever stop? Along comes a war. I can assure you, the battlefield would extend well beyond the borders of my body alone.
So, you and Lazelle. Seems tense.
Please don't remind me. But keep your guard up with her.
Note. Shadow. Such a grim name for such a beautiful flower.
Could you not stare so blatantly in my neck when you say that, please?
Oh, but do keep calling her flower. She'll love that. Gale is positively voracious. Well, let him suck up all the magic he needs, as long as he doesn't snack on a Githyanki silver sword.
Need anything else? Of course, but please, remember, you're not the only one in need. Sylvanas be with you.
Indolence breeds madness.
Refugees, adventurers, no one in years, and suddenly we're overwhelmed. Well met. And thank you for beating back those goblins. Most brave of you. Is there anything you need? Act fast if you do. The ritual will be complete before too long. Just some bits and bobs I no longer need. Sylvanas, guide your path.